Well, it's been some day already at the US Darts Masters here at the Tropicana in Las Vegas. And Barry Hearn, PDC chairman, has joined us in commentary to reflect on what we've seen so far and to look ahead to what we can possibly expect in the future. The North American champion, Willie J. Bruyer, came close to beating Gerwyn Price. David Cameron here trying to upset Raymond van Barneveld. You see Dave Richardson go through against Max Hopp. Here he is, the man from Halifax, Nova Scotia, against Raymond van Barneveld, who has suffered first-round exits in World Series events before. Famously, I remember in Australia, I think the first time he were in Sydney, he lost to Clinton Tickbridge in the first round. We shall see, but it's been pretty good so far.
No, I think we've all enjoyed it, and as I said last night before the game starts today, to be honest, every leg is a victory for American darters, because they're not expected to ruffle the feathers of the top players in the world. But one of them already has, and the others have lost gallantly. I hope in the process learnt a huge lesson on where they've got to get their game to be competitive on the world stage, because frankly, it's looking very good here in Vegas.
Well, the sold-out signs as well here at the Tropicana, and that certainly augurs well. The American darts public have responded.
Well, also we get the overnight TV figures, which we had this morning, and particularly on the East Coast. And bear in mind that that's not going out until 12:30 at night. The figures were probably two or three times what was expected. So, without being complacent, there's a long way to go. But this is very, very encouraging for darts players in America.
80. Barney with the darts in the opening leg. The winner of this, by the way, will possibly be playing Gary Anderson in the quarterfinals. Anderson last match on against Jason Barlow, one of the North American qualifiers.
58.
No pressure on Barney in the opening leg. I remember him beating Anderson in Shanghai with some brilliant finishing. Got to go for it. Oh, unlucky. A wry smile, but that would have been a showstopper. And that's what they want, the American audiences. They want to be entertained, I guess.
I think it's a big difference when you look at someone like Van Bember. With the experience he's got around the world, he's pretty unfazable, isn't he? He's been there and bought the T-shirt.
18.
And frankly, his experience alone should be enough to see him through in this game, but Cameron's got his chance. He's playing one of the legends of the game with nothing to lose.
42.
Well, I just missed the ball for a big finish.
Game shot.
A double 16 will do for Barney to take the opening leg. A semi-finalist in Shanghai. Cameron lost to young Canadian Dawson Michel in the North American Championship.
51.
This is the 22nd World Series dance event since we started in Dubai in 2013. There were three ever presents. Phil Taylor, who's not here through illness. Michael van Gerwen, who will miss the Australian leg in August because his wife is about to give birth to their first child, and Raymond van Barneveld, who will take over the mantle as the only World Series ever present.
And what a journey it's been, Stuart. You know, I think people raised their eyebrows when we said we were going to launch it. Didn't know whether we'd see the same type of response that we see so often in the UK and particularly in Europe. But then we went and sold 16,000 tickets the first time we went to Auckland in New Zealand, and people started to sit up and take notice and believe that there is a future. Of course, it's been followed up with succession after session of sold-out crowds. January, as I said, we launched PDC China in January. Who would have thought that 5 years, 10 years ago, unthinkable, that we are now entering into a new major market. And today we're in Vegas with the biggest crowds we've ever seen, with the biggest TV ratings we've ever seen, and you get the feeling it's going to happen again.
That tangible support then for darts in China, on the ground support. to boost the game.
Yeah, I mean, PDC are opening an office in Beijing. We're going to get involved with local governments to encourage kids across the country. We know there's 2 billion of them, so we only want half will be fine, actually. Half of them will be fine. But it's great. I mean, even the USA, there's 300 million in the USA, an estimated 30 million people throw a dart in some capacity once a month. So you've got 10% of the population to build on. And it is, of course, the land of dreams. America's supposed to be the land of opportunity. Well, these darts players are getting theirs, and it's up to them how much advantage they take of it.
55.
All about, I guess, encouraging the next generation in the USA as well.
I think you saw it with young Dawson yesterday, 21 years old, looks a quality player in the making. You know, we've got a North Dakota policeman that suddenly achieved his dreams. He's going to London to play in the big, on the biggest stage of all. And those stories go down, they filter down, they inspire youngsters, they inspire other people to work harder. But, you know, it's tough. There's $20 million of prize money next year, and you can change your life, but it's tough. And so it should be. Rewards are not easily gained.
Cameron had one dart, just one dart to level up. Barney finally nails at double four to take control of this game.
Great shot at the crowds there, Stuart. They've really been here. They've become part of the whole show, as they are at most darts events. Players are important. The fans are actually as important because they make the show as much as the players sometimes.
Yeah, partisan, and so they should be. Chanting USA, USA earlier on.
Well, if you, can't take, was the, playing, if you yeah. can't take the heat in the kitchen, you know, don't turn the oven on. And if you want to be part of this wonderful global circus, you've got to put up with that.
65.
You know, look at Barnfield. His throw doesn't change, does it? Still silky smooth, no matter where he's playing or who they're chanting for. Although it has to be said, he quite prefers the Ahoy Stadium when there's 11,000 Dutch people chanting Barney's Army.
Premier League in Rotterdam. What an experience that was.
And next year, of course, Mercedes Stadium in Berlin. 12,000 Germans going crazy for a game that 5 years ago we sold 50 tickets to in our first event.
Yeah. I remember the first ever Premier League night in Stoke.
Yep.
900.
I think the 900 might have been a promotional exaggeration. It was probably a lot less, but now, of course, 96% of Premier League tickets sold out throughout the event. 120,000 people turned up on a Thursday night to watch darts, and that's a statement of where we've come. And one of those players that's been there ever present is Raymond van Barneveld, a 3-0 lead and looking silky smooth. So it's going to be difficult to get anything off van Barneveld in this mood.
So the Premier League back to Holland and heading to Berlin in Germany for the first time. Difficult here, I guess, in America, because it's such a huge place. So is it a case of laying down roots or concrete plans? How do you go about it?
Well, you form a structure, don't you? You create local events to feed international events that in time become international events. America, we're at the local event stage. China, we're at the local event stage. You know, Holland and Germany, we're into international stage. Other countries are in the middle. But it's all about producing strong domestic talent. Every country needs its own hero. America in particular needs Americans to chant for. And that's the excitement of it, because the world's our oyster. We are, as I said yesterday, on our way, in a sporting sense, to global domination. Most sports today can't live with darts. The millennial customer, with a reasonably short attention span, is warming to the social and the sporting activities of an evening at the darts. It's brought in an entirely different demographic, and it's a demographic that appeals to both broadcasters and sponsors. In short, darts has it all, and Cameron has one leg on the leg, on the table.
Yeah, good response from the Canadian. Get a leg off van Barneveld. So in terms of the project, do you set yourself a target? Is it within 3 years, 5 years, 10 years? It's a long-term goal.
Well, fortunately, as a global sport, we come armed with international television contracts, so that does make the first entry a lot less expensive. We're not selling a product that's unknown. What we need to do is develop strong domestic links in each country, and then we set ourselves basically a three-year term to say, right, we want to see something really positive out of this. And positivity usually is local, is community values, really, more than anything else. Because today, you know, the workers of the world, the blue-collar workers protesting America, in some ways they're unsung heroes, and they need a platform, and darts can give them exactly that.
85.
One thing's for sure, these US players and their fans and families are going to go home after this event motivated to be better.
And wanting more.
And that's mission accomplished as far as I'm concerned.
So a chance here. Four visits from Barney. Maybe six darts from 140 for Cameron.
60.
Well, these are the finishes that he was taking out in China in beating Gary Anderson. Not now, so a chance for Cameron to break the Barney throw and get back to within just a leg. Well, he missed a dart at tops in the second leg, a dart at tops in the fifth leg. Can't afford to do that. Pressure now.
30.
Well, it's never over till the fat lady sings, and Mr. Cameron has an unexpected chance. Which he takes. That's a big, big leg for the American. Big leg. Sorry, the Canadian.
Breaks, 3-2, throwing to make it 3 apiece.
Game on.
I wonder if Barney is feeling the heat. It's been 110 degrees plus in Vegas all week. Pretty hot on that stage as well.
One.
But you've certainly seen enough in the last couple of days to be encouraged. Very encouraged?
Very encouraged. The attitude, the atmosphere created by the fans here is very fulfilling. It actually incentivises you to go that extra yard because you feel everyone's on your side. And we all feel in darts, I think we have done for the last 10 years, that we've been on a bit of a journey, an unexpected hero journey. Because, you know, you go back in the history of darts and say, oh, it's the archers in the Middle Ages that broke their arrows and went to owl houses and used the broken arrow to throw at targets. So we're a game that's been around a long, long time, but no one's ever actually anticipated where we would be today. And sometimes it takes getting used to. A lot of people still don't buy into this perception of ordinary people with extraordinary talent, because that sums up darts.
From what you're saying, certainly in North America and in China, it's more evolution than revolution.
Yeah, I think it's easier sometimes to take it to new markets than established markets, because the perception has already been, it's in your mindset, darts is darts. When you go to countries outside of your comfort zone, we're actually treated like superheroes and superstars because basically they are. But sometimes at home you don't get the same benefit. That perception is changing, particularly with broadcasters, when they see the ratings that Sky TV in the UK, darts is the second highest rated sport behind Premier League football. When you say something like that, you start thinking of it, darts, as in a different way. You have to understand the target market. They are our customers. They are the customers of the world, because they're ordinary people coming to watch extraordinary talent. And once you get your head round it, then you can see a lot more opportunities all over the world, whether we're talking Scandinavia with the Scandinavian Tour, or Eastern Europe with their amazing events out there. It's not slowing down. And what's not slowing down here is Mr. Barnbell's giving Cameron a few chances.
Oh, he's taking them, yeah. A couple more misses from Barney. He looked comfortable, didn't he, at 3-0, Raymond van Barneveld. Different game now.
One.
this would be a real upset.
It's fascinating watching the mindset changes. Barney started off looking so smooth, as if he completely unruffled. And the American think he's quite proud to be on the same stage as such a great player. And then all of a sudden the window opens and the opportunity exists. And suddenly it's 3-3 and you can actually see the mindset. Now Barney's got to dig in, hasn't he? But for Cameron all of a sudden he's 3 away from a massive scalp.
In many ways, Barney continues to be a flag bearer, doesn't he? Still, you know, huge name in the world of darts in the 10 years that he's been with the PDC as well.
Well, he's earned. You only get in life and in sport what you earn, don't you? You can't demand success, and Barney's paid his price. He's paid his dues. He's established himself as a superstar within the sport. But with the competition that exists today, you can't rest on your laurels. You know, Barney's not getting any younger. He's aware Phil Taylor's on his last victory lap, if you like, before retirement, and it comes to everybody. And of course, you don't want it to end when you're enjoying yourself. Barney really enjoys World Series. He loves going to different countries. He loves being applauded by people around the world on the basis of what he's achieved, and quite rightly too. But it doesn't last forever, and you get hungry lungs like that, throwing a 180 and saying, I want a bit of this cake.
Well, if ever he needed a big, big finish in the World Series.
89.
Barney yet to win a World Series event, despite playing in every single World Series tournament. Bullseye. He had a chance. Now he can't afford to miss that Barneveld. What a big dart this is. Oh. The dart of experience.
Oh, you can't buy the fact that his nerve ends over the years, of course, have been shattered, so he doesn't feel the same nerves that mere mortals do. He threw that with silky smoothness and it was slotted straight in the spot, but 4-3 up and 4-3 down is a massive step. To have you lose your throw on that would have been potentially disastrous for Barney. Now he can settle again.
One.
Well, he's being pushed. Still to come, James Wade, Peter Wright, Michael Van Gerwen, Gary Anderson on the first day of this US Darts Masters here in Las Vegas.
16.
I think they've got used to the idea of signs over here.
Perhaps need a little bit more imagination with what they're writing on the signs.
Well, you know, you do see fans that have a sense of humour, and some of them are classics, yeah, that you see, you know. But we also have to have security making sure that no one's putting up any naughty
that's
signs,
right,
because that's an ejection. You don't want to buy a ticket and lose out on the entertainment, so we ask everyone to be sensible, and they are. Very well behaved.
Straight red card,
but the huge majority of darts fans, as you can see, just enjoying the experience. And in a world with so many troubles, isn't it just pleasant to just close the door behind you, watch world-class sport in a party atmosphere, relax, and then go back to normality the day after?
We all fly home to normality on Sunday.
Mr. Cameron puts even more pressure on Van Barneveld. This is brilliant to watch.
Yeah, darting normality. Two and two legs for...
Well, he's got a dart. He's got a dart. 8 for the lid.
Oh, Barneveld. Yeah, we have it. That could be the dart that wins it, Barrett.
That's class. That's pure class. And of course, when you say back to normality, it's not really, is it, Stuart? It's back to normality in a few days later. It's the world match play with, what, nearly $1 million of prize money. 16 top seeds, 16 qualifiers. I would say arguably the second biggest tournament in the world, wouldn't you?
Yeah, absolutely. Then the World Series kicks in again. Auckland, Melbourne for the first time, and Perth in August.
And then straight back for the champion of champions, the top eight. It's a never-ending circus. It's a merry-go-round. And don't we all love every single second? And we're honoured, really honoured to be involved in a sport with so much progress. So much opportunity. It's very, very motivating.
Yeah, the world match play, Michael van Gerwen going for three on the spin.
Phil Taylor trying to win his 17th title in his final year. Lots of drama.
Here, Michael van Gerwen looking to win a 10th World Series title. Incredible to think. 9 wins and 6 runners-up places for van Gerwen in World Series darts.
He is a machine at the moment, but, you know, machines have to be oiled and machines break down. He is, after all, and someone may not agree with me, but he is only human. 19. Barney cruising here for victory now, looking, got over his little mental aberration. 66. And Mr. Cameron can lead the stage with a lot of credit. He's put up a good fight against one of the legends of the game.
Tops it is.
31.
But Barney will be back. He's been pushed certainly by the Canadian.
1 minute 40.
Just reminding the Dutch giant that he's still there. Can he finish it here?
Game, shot.
Well, he gets there in the end. Ruben van Barneveld goes through to the quarterfinals, but Barney was pushed all the way.
Great effort, and Cameron's going to learn more from that in defeat than he would have learned in victory.